JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for July the 23rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other major currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It gained versus CHF, the euro, and the Japanese yen in that order, while it underperformed against the pound, the Aussie, the Kiwi, and the Canadian dollar. The weakening of the franc and the yen, combined with the slight strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie, Kiwi, and Loonie, suggests that markets continued to trade in a risk-on fashion yesterday. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices traded in the green, with the only exception being UK's FTSE 100, which may have slid due to a strengthening pound. Remember that many companies of the index generate profits in other currencies, so in a strengthening GBP environment, if those profits are converted to pounds, they worth less. Appetite, although relatively softer, remained supported during the US session as well, but deteriorated further today in Asia. In our view, market participants continue to buy stocks as a result of having second thoughts over the potential economic impact of the fast-spreading Delta variant of the coronavirus. As we've been highlighting the last couple of days, with vaccinations limiting the severity of symptoms of new cases, new measures may not be as restrictive as previously. Investors may have kept increasing their risk exposure also due to the outcome of the ECB monetary policy decision. As was widely expected, the bank kept all of its settings untouched and changed its forward guidance, saying that it will keep interest rates at present or lower levels until it sees inflation reaching 2% well ahead of the end of its projection horizon, which may also imply a period during which inflation moderately overshoots that objective. This translates into willingness to hold rates low for much longer than the previous guidance suggested. The euro gained initially, perhaps due to the lack of a more dovish outcome, as what we got was what was expected. However, it pulled back later in the day to be found as the second biggest loser today morning, as investors may have resumed their monetary policy divergence bets. With the ECB pledging to stay ultra loose for longer, while the Fed and the RBNZ have already started discussing the timing of when they should start withdrawing support, we do see the case for euro dollar and euro kiwi to drift south in the foreseeable future. Now, as for today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK retail sales for June, with the headline rate rebounding by more than expected and the core one rebounding by less than anticipated. Later in the day, we have the preliminary PMIs for July from the Eurozone, the UK and the US. In the Euro area, the manufacturing index is expected to decline to 62.5 from 63.4, while the services one is forecast to rise to 59.6 from 58.3. This is likely to take the composite index slightly higher to 60 from 59.5. Although this would mean some further recovery in the bloc's economy, we doubt that it would be enough to lift the euro. especially with the coronavirus Delta variant posing fresh risks to the economy, and the ECB pledged to keep its policy extra loose for longer. In the UK, all indices are expected to decline somewhat, while the US ones are forecast to come in on the mixed side. The manufacturing one is expected to slide somewhat, while the services one is forecast to have inched fractionally higher. Canada's retail sales for May are also due to be released, with both headline and core sales expected to have continued to slide, but at a slower pace than in April. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.